Hi, my name is Philip, professor at the Shenzhen University. Today I will talk to you about our paper on sequence prediction using episode rules. So let's start. So first, the topic of this paper is sequence prediction. What is this? So let's say we have a sequence, as you can see here, about some events A, B, C, D that appear over time. We have the time T1, T2, T3, and so on. So this sequence means AC is followed by A, then by the events A, B, and so on. And sequence prediction, we want to predict what will happen after, do the prediction. So to do this, we will use episode rule mining. That means we look at the sequence of events for training and we try to find some rules. If we have AC, then there will be B and so on. That we'll use to make some prediction. So in this paper, we compare three types of rules: episode rules, precise positioning episode rules, and a new type of rule we call the partially ordered episode rules, to compare which one is the most accurate and so on. Okay. So let me explain the three types of rules very briefly. We have the standard episode rules proposed in the MinePy algorithm, which is a rule is like this. If we have a sequence of events, it will be followed by some other events. So let's look at the example. We have the sequence of events say C followed by A, and this implies that there will be D after. So for example, C followed by A is followed by D. So we say that this rule has one occurrence from T1 to T3, okay, here. Another example, we have the rule A followed by C imply that D will happen after. So these rules appear between time 5 to 8, for example, in the sequence. So using episode rule mining, we can find the rule like this. And to find the rules, we use some parameter called the support and confidence. We want to find the rules that appear at least some minimum number of time, that have a minimum support, and also minimum confidence. That means the conditional probability. So this is the brief idea. Let me show you the second type of rules. We call the precise positioning episode rule, proposed in another paper. They are found by the PRU algorithm. So this kind of rule, let me show you just an example. It say that B followed by D, one time unit later will be followed by A. So here, for example, we have B followed by D, and one time unit after, actually it means two times unit, if you look here, there will be A, okay. Another example, we have BD followed by A. So BD and two times unit, it means three, there will be A, for example. So we say this rule appears. So all these rules are popular, used in several papers. And now here we have a new type of rule. What is special is that the events in the left part of the rule and the right part have no order. So let's look at this rule, for example. A, B, C in any order will be followed by D. So, for example, here we have A, B, C any order followed by D. A, B, C any order followed by D. So we say the rule appear between T1 to T3 and time 5 to time 8, for example. Okay, so we want to do sequence prediction. If we do prediction, we use a prefix. If we see some events in the prefix, we want to guess what will happen after in the suffix. So we can do the good prediction, the wrong prediction, or maybe we are unable to make the prediction. So we use a simple framework. We use the sequence, the training, to find the rules. And then using the rules, our model, we have a new sequence and we do the prediction to test the accuracy and so on. So we did some experiment on different database that have different timestamps and number of events, and we use different parameters to find the rules, the confidence, the minimum support, the number of events for the prediction, the prefix, and also the suffix. So here I show you briefly some results. Here we look at the influence of the minimum support on the accuracy, the matching rate, how many times we can do the prediction, and the number of rules for four database A, B, C, D. So here we have our rules. PoERM is our rules and the two other type of rules found by the other algorithm. So briefly, we can see our rule can give the better accuracy. This line, this line, this line, and this line. Okay. When we change the parameter, we have more rules, more accuracy, and so on, but our algorithm always the best. We did also experiment for the confidence. We have similar results. And for the prefix size, if we have more information, sometime we can do better prediction and so on. We also evaluate the suffix size and so on. So briefly, because this is a short presentation, we evaluate a new type of rules we call the partially ordered episode rules. Because we don't have order in the antecedent and consequent, it allows us to do the better sequence prediction in terms of accuracy matching rate. So there are several possibilities for future work, including using the more complex data. If you want to find the code and data for this paper, you can find in the SPMF data mining library. Thank you very much for listening to my talk. Thank you.